In 1947, the New York Yankees beat the Brooklyn Dodgers in a dramatic 7-game World Series. With the Yanks up 2-1, Game 4 at Ebbets Field was a beauty. At that time, nobody had ever pitched a World Series no-hitter. Yankee right-hander Bill Bevins was wild, walking 10 Dodgers, but he had not given up a hit going into the bottom of the ninth. Bevins and the Yanks led the ballgame 2-1. With two outs and two on, here is Red Barber to make his most historic call.
Eddie Stanky is stepping in. Wait a minute. Stanky is being called back from the plate, and Lavagello goes up to hit. The Yankees are ahead 2-1. Gianfrido, the pinch runner's at second, the tying run. Mixes the winning runs at first base. Both have them on with walks, both the pinch runners. No hits by Bevins. 8 2/3 innings. Two out last of the night. The pitch to Lavagello, swung on and missed. A fastball. It was in there. Strike one. Gianfrido walks off second. Mixes off first. They're both ready to go on anything. Two men out. Last of the night. The pitch swung on. There's a drive hit out toward the right field corner. Henrik is going back. He can't get it. It's off the wall for a base hit. Here comes the tying run. And here comes the winning run. Friends, they're killing Lavagello, his own teammates. They are beating him to pieces, and it's taken a police escort to get Lavagello away from the Dodgers.
Red enjoyed another memorable moment in Game 6 of that World Series. At Yankee Stadium, Dodgers ahead 8-5, needing a win to force Game 7. In the sixth inning with two outs, Yankee clipper Joe DiMaggio represented the tying run.
Joe leans in. Outfield deep, round toward left, the infield overshifted. Here's the pitch. Swung on, belted. It's a long one. Deep into left center. Back for Gianfrido. Back, 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 back. He makes a one-handed catch against the bullpen. Oh, doctor.
Interestingly, after the 47 World Series, neither Gianfrido nor Bevins would ever appear in another big league game. Later, Red said he was pleased with those calls, and he should have been. He was dramatic but under control and captured the moments brilliantly. At times like those, as a live performer, you have no idea what will happen in the game. Therefore, you also have no idea what you are going to say. You just hope the words tumble out in the proper order. Simultaneously, it is both exhilarating and terrifying. In 1947, Red Barber was at the top of his game, and he would reach even greater heights. But in earlier days, his perch had not been nearly as lofty.